Going to discuss about what is a lexical analyzer and what are the different phases in lexical analyzer or different what is the responsibility of a lexical analyzer. As I in the previous video, as I told you, what are the different phases in compiler, and the first phase of the compiler process is the lexical analyzer. So lexical analyzer, it reads the total high level language program one character at a time. It breaks the program into something called as tokens. Okay, so the lexical analyzer generally gives a stream of tokens, and there are two terms. Number one is a lexemes and second one is token, and the definition between these two terms is very ambiguous. Sometimes students get very you know, frustrated between these two terms. What is a lexeme and a token? Do one thing, just after this video, search what is a lexeme and a token on Google, and then the next video or maybe next two or three videos, I'm going to explain what is the difference between a lexeme and a token. So it removes the white spaces and it removes the comments, and it maintains the line number of the program. This is important. It maintains the line number of the program. It creates the storage for identifier into the symbol table. Okay, let me explain it to you again. If you have a program like this, this is some hash define statement, hash define ns5. Then you have a main function. Inside this main function, we have some kind of comments, like this is a comment, and we can have some statements, maybe like a is equal to a plus b, and so on. There are different statements like this, and there are some line numbers related to this. For example, this may be line number 1, this may be line number 2, this may be line number 3, line number 4, and so on. Maybe this is line number, actually it should be line number 3, it should be 4, it should be 5, and so on. Now when we discuss about the lexical analysis phase, now this lexical analyzer is going to remove all the new line characters from the program. That means it is just we are including the new line character so that the user will be able to understand the program, but the compiler does not require the new line character. So if you are going to remove all the new line characters from this particular program, then this entire program will come within a single line. But generally, you see, when we show some kind of errors, then we show that there's an error with this particular line, or there's some compile time error for a particular line. So if the lexical analyzer is going to remove all the extra line spaces, white spaces, and all the new line characters, then obviously we are going to lose all the line numbers. So it is a responsibility of lexical analyzer to maintain the line numbers for the program. Okay. Second, it creates storage for identifiers in the symbol table. And what is a symbol table? Symbol table is something we are going to maintain, a table which is going to store all the information about symbols. And what are symbols? Symbol means, even if you have a function like this, there's a fun function, and there are some, you know, program which is related to the fun function. You may be having some kind of variables, like we have integer a and b. Now this a and b are also symbol, but they are also called as identifiers. Okay, now when we execute this entire program, then we should know where this particular function is stored, and this function will be acting as a symbol. Just do one thing, when you execute a C language program, just write the following program like this, exactly like this: hash include stdio.h, then we have a main function, and then we are going to have a fun function. We are calling a fun function like this. But if you execute this particular program, then you'll see there's some kind of error with this program, and that error is a compile time error. That error will say there's no fun function which does exist. The fun function does not exist at all. Why? It will not exactly say the fun function. It will say that we cannot find the symbol which is fun. This fun itself is acting as a symbol. Okay. So you can view it like this. Fine. So the responsibility of this lexical analyzer is to create storage or for identifiers in the symbol tables, right? So if you have an identifier like a and b, it is going to create a storage for this, where we are going to store the actual information. Let me just give you a very simple example of this. Don't worry, some of my statements may look very contradictory to you. Don't worry, I'll explain it to you very everything line by line. We'll see it. Don't worry. Okay, so just assume that we have the following single line. It is saying if x is greater than 3.1, right? Now in this particular line, this if itself, this complete itself, it is a keyword. There are multiple keywords which are defined, like we have else is a keyword, right? So if is a keyword, else is a keyword, there's something called as break, which is a keyword. So there are some keywords which are present in a program. Now we have a opening bracket, we have a variable x, we have this greater than or equal less than sign, then we have 3.1. Now this entire statement is given to the lexical analyzer, and so that we are just giving a character stream to this lexical analyzer, and this lexical analyzer is going to create a token stream. Token stream means it is going to separate all the keywords, all the brackets. So keywords, identifiers, operators and numbers into separate tokens, and then we are going to work on this token. That means we'll try to see if this is a valid string or not, or you can say will this is a valid sentence or not. So you can say the lexical analyzer separates characters from the source language into group that logically belong together, which are known as tokens. And the usual tokens are keywords, identifiers, operators and special symbols. Okay, so let us look at this, discuss about this in the next video. What are these keywords, identifiers, operators, special symbols, etc. Okay, let me take more examples for the lexical analyzer.